Camp Christmas.
Andy, aren't you?
Yes, Melissa, Christmas Eve is always so exciting. And we've rented this log cabin for the perfect dream vacation.
Mm. And we're going to have a lovely traditional Christmas, just the kind like I read in my family circle.
Just us and a few of our very special friends.
All prepared? Have you been gathering your winter fuel?
Yes, I've got a couple of pine cones to make Christmas decorations out of.
Oh, good. Yes, it's going to be just like the Christmases I remember back in Kansas, where I grew up, where we used to sleep under the tree and wait for Santa Claus to come. And you know what? We never saw Santa Claus. But in the morning, we'd wake up and there'd be tons of presents. And we'd get up and we'd have turkey and we'd have mashed potatoes and pecan pie. And, well, where did you spend your Christmases?
Peterborough.
Well, we'll recapture all of that magic, shall we?
Why don't you come in and share the fun?
Hi there,
Justin.
How you
doing? How you like the tree? Oh, it's not bad for a footballer.
Where's Derek?
Yeah, where's Derek and Simon?
Oh, behind you.
Woo, making crackers.
Crackers and presents.
We are crackers.
Jokes and crackers. Jokes and crackers. Have you heard about the gay Pope, who was simply divine? How many gay men does it take to change a light bulb? Don't let's talk about the light bulb, honey. Let's talk about the shade. What's the worst present you can give a lesbian for Christmas?
I don't know.
Martina's phone number with one digit wrong.
Oi, don't do that.
It's a gas fire, not a real one. You'll block up my chute.
And which of Santa's reindeer were you?
Well, my name's Whitney. And I'm the provocative one. Too gorgeous to stay in line, too dangerous for the image of the firm. I was thrown out because the jingle of my nipple clamps interfered with the sleigh bells. So here I am, keeping a rather glassy eye on things.
Well, it's a job, I suppose.
Hello, log cabin.
Yeah, hi guys. I'm calling to wish you Merry Christmas.
Marcina, how are you?
I'm just great, thank you. I wish I were there, but I couldn't make it. I'm busy skiing here in Aspen, sorry.
Oh, thanks for the presents, Marcina.
Yeah, I hope you like them. I took a lot of time to pick them out, so I hope you enjoy them.
So what are you doing now?
Well, I'm skiing and I'm fixing up my tree. It doesn't look so hot right now, but hopefully by the evening it's going to look smashing.
Oh, I hope you have a really good Christmas and hope to see you next year.
Okay, thanks. Have a great one. Bye.
Thank you. Bye.
Presents! Here they are. This for you. Presents exactly like I had in Kansas. You know, Mom and Dad used to dress up as Santa Claus and everything. Look, freedom rings.
Fantastic. Oh.
I think that'll be the caterers.
Savage Catering? You'll remember us in the morning.
Watch out for the salmonella mousse.
Oh, what a nut. Oh, what a bone alette, dear.
Oh, my God. Little house on the prairie. Look at it.
Right, what's in your trolley, Polly?
Well, it's a little something we made earlier, dear. Oh, daughter.
Come on, let's have the cling film off these. Hang on to it, though, in case it's an orgy. Do you think they're going to notice that you dropped them, Polly?
No, not, dear. Oh, eat your heart out. Oh, you are sloppy.
This man makes my nipples go like footballs.
Oh!
Don't be worrying about the food. They're Americans, aren't they? You know what Yanks are like. They'll eat anything. Just slap a bit of tomato.
Hi there. Hello. You all right? Everything okay?
Yes, dear.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, dear. Lovely.
Good evening, sir.
Oh, Merry Christmas, sir.
Did you manage to get the stove working?
Well, we are familiar with electrical and gas appliances. Thank you.
She knows all about appliances. She's got a catalogue. What?
Good luck.
Thank you, dear. Sit out. Well, I do love a vol-au-vent, dear, don't you?
I think I've got time to mess around in Argus. We've got little things for me. Dog girl.
What, dear?
Let's give them ulcers.
What is that, a moose?
I'm Whitney the reindeer. What or who are you?
I'm Leah the warrior.
Sounds more like a magic mushroom.
I don't have to take that from a dog with a thyroid trust. Eat your heart out, you're so butch, dear.
Don't call me Big Dyke for nothing.
There, Bambi. Would you like one of these little vol-au-vents, or is your jaw wired up?
Well, yes, but not to stop me eating.
I don't believe this, Polly. I'm talking to a hat stand.
It is so nice to be with friends for the holidays. It's so good to see you, baby.
But, Leah, won't you miss your family at Christmas?
Family, Pat, don't you know? At your parents' house, no one can hear you scream. Are you kidding? That's why I'm going to give myself the greatest Christmas present a person can give. I am not going home for the holidays. Yay! That's right, no. I'm not going home for the hetero fest, the big gathering of the guineas that are always at my house. Because let me tell you, when we have Christmas, we have Christmas! You know, and the whole family is there, Andy. The whole entire family is there. And who's always there? We're Italians, right? So who's there? The little old Italian aunts. Tiny little aunties. 90-year-old women that stand about this tall because Italian women never die, they just shrink out of existence. Sit. Sit down. They just get smaller and smaller. I've got two of them, Sophie and Vincenza. They're like little auntie bookends, you know? They stand there. They're both the same woman, basically. They have the same black scarf right on the head, same black dress. They can do a rosary in 5 seconds flat, these women, okay? Right? And they know not, they are fascinated by me. Fascinated by me. Whenever I come home, they follow me around. Wherever I go. They speak no English except for one word, one sentence, which they utter at me constantly. So when are you going to get married? When are you going to get married? When are you going to get married? Oh, probably when I stop eating pussy. So that's it. I am not going home. Not at all. Not at all. Because I'll tell you why. Because I'll tell you why. Honestly, it is very hard to be queer and Italian. See? Yeah. Because Italians, with very little exception, are raised Catholic. Ha! And Catholics believe, and they base their entire faith on this one single belief, that if you ignore something, it will go away. It will disappear. It will go away. Take the Pope, Pope John Paul II. Right, the traveling Pope, he's been everywhere but the realm of reality, okay? Right here? Pope John Paul says, did you hear this? It's okay to be a homosexual as long as you don't participate in homosexual acts. Which is great with me because I think it's okay to be Catholic as long as you don't participate in Catholicism, right? So I'll never forget when I came out. When I came out to my parents, I did the good gay thing. Total gay thing. Mom, Dad, I'm gay, right? And they did the good Italian thing. Screaming, fighting, yelling, throwing things, and then they forgot about it. Yeah, we had to do the whole thing again. I'd come home, they'd have strange men sitting at the kitchen table, right? Seriously, they'd be like, Leah. Meet Bob Bell. I'd be like, who the heck is Bob Bell? Mom, remember that conversation we had like a month ago? You threw the dinette through the window. Remember that conversation, right? And finally, I'd have to get rid of these guys, right? So finally, I walked up to this guy, and I said, look, Bob Bell. I am not interested in you. And it's not that I don't like penises. I just don't like them on men. So no, I'm not going home for the holidays. I'm spending it with my friends and presents! I have some others, but I just wanted to give these to you now because I know you're just going to love them. Merry Christmas, Andy.
Thank you.
You too, Melissa. Merry Christmas. I'm gonna put these others right under the tree.
The Queen's Christmas speech on Christmas Eve.
Haven't you heard of cable?
I am speaking to you all today via the modern marvel of electric television. Whether you're at home, abroad, or in ships at sea. As you all know, this year marks 40 years since I won this pageant, when I was hired and given a sash for my interest in horse riding, traveling, and meeting people. I believe the chief difference between then and now is that in 1953, a man named Hillary climbed his way to the top, whereas in 93, a woman named Hillary has done the same, with a cheerful assistant ever at her side. In this time, I have dined with kings, lunched with presidents, picked nervously at my plate with New Guinea Highland headhunters, and I have spoken in English with President Ronald Reagan at his retreat, Camp David. Tonight, though, I am most delighted to participate in this Camp Christmas. I am very happy to patronize you all. Queens have always patronized the arts, and the arts have always relied upon the support of queens. Christmas is a time for hope for the future and good cheer. When we remember those absent, as well as those of you watching this special broadcast with Andy and Melissa at the Lodge. At home in these islands, much has changed in 40 years. What has not changed is the people's loyalty and warmth of affection. So different from Cyprus, Germany, Australia, which I'm told is developing as a whole that it is. is developing as a whole. The fact it is already progressing is undoubted since its discovery in the 1970s by Thomas Cook. You may find it surprising that one is not particularly disheartened by their recent discussion about becoming a repatriate. Republic. Yeah, that wasn't so hard. But what I shall be most disappointed about is that I normally pick up 40,000 points on the Qantas frequent flyer program. I leave you with my new party piece, which I shall be performing for my whole family tomorrow on Christmas Day. Annus horribilis, ones bum year, Amos cognoscenti. Don't you think it's queer? Sid Angelus Angli, though the choir boy hummeth. Nullus comprehendi, I feel quite numbeth. Mungus superfluous, our cup overrunneth. Halus a taxibus, the taxman cometh. Media interruptus, the dirty tricks game. Coitus extramaritus, blackens one's name. Camilla Fuchs intersit, they meet on the hunt. Kinta et tampax, to be perfectly blunt. Telephonus mobile, give us a ring. Restum compressum, press the tit thing. Exodus old timers, 93 out the door. Campus Christmas, where else? Channel 4. May God bless you all.
I guess I'm not in Kansas anymore. How about a song? Would you like to hear a nice Christmas song?
Yeah. Yeah.
About Santa Claus, maybe? You better watch out. You better not cry. You better not pout. I'm telling you why. Santa Claus is coming to town. Santa Claus is coming to town. Santa Claus is coming to town. I tell you, he's making a list. He's checking it twice. And he's gonna find out who's naughty or nice. Santa Claus is coming to town. Santa Claus is coming to town. Santa Claus is coming to town. Well, he sees you when you're sleeping. He knows if you're awake. He knows if you've been bad or good. Huh. You better be good, for goodness sake. You better watch out. You better not cry. You better not pout. I'm telling you why. Santa Claus is coming to town. Oh, Santa Claus is coming to town. Santa Claus. Claus is coming to death. Oh, 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 yeah.
Thank you, guys. Thank you.
The travel business is large.
Take me to the Emerald City, down yellow brick roads fast I run. Scarecrow friends will dance beside me, tin toy brothers, brighter sun. Take me to the Emerald City, wizards will give us lemonade. It's a land of pleasures plenty, ruby roses never fade. Children gather fragile flowers, stars will sing a lullaby. You're an angel take me to the Emerald City. Wizards will give us lemonade. It's a land of pleasures pretty. Ruby roses never fade. Tinsel teardrops, rivers flow through jungles tall. Witches watch through magic mirrors. Frosted fog covers crystal balls. Take me to the Emerald City. Wizards will give us lemonade. It's a land of pleasures pretty. Ruby roses never fade. It's a land of pleasures pretty. Ruby roses never fade.
Watch carefully.
Okay.
What's that one?
Ten of hearts.
And what's that one?
Ten of spades.
Okay, look away. Because he's got to look away and make it work. Okay, you can look now. You can look now.
Oh,
look
now. Sorry. Okay. Ten of spades.
In this pocket, yeah?
Okay.
Ten of hearts.
Okay.
Now, what's in this pocket?
Ten of hearts.
What's in this pocket?
Ten of spades.
I didn't think you'd do it.
Works look,
every
now,
time.
Look, I found there's a poll in the Times, a Murray poll about Christmas, and in it it says that 66% of people drink alcohol at Christmas, 79% of people watch television, which means there's 23% of people in Britain last year who watched the Paul Daniels magic special sober. Barbara Streisand.
I'll get it. Hello?
Melissa, it's Armistead.
Hi, Melissa.
Hi, where are you? Why aren't you here?
Oh, we're in San Francisco. We're kind of holed up here for the holidays. I've been reading to Terry from A Christmas Carol. It's kind of an annual tradition with us. We've done it for the past 6 years.
Seven.
Terry's not exactly into it.
Oh, well, I'd love to hear it.
You would. Okay, well, shall I put it on speakerphone?
Please.
Go on. Once upon a time, of all the good days in the year on Christmas Eve, old Scrooge sat busy in his counting house. It was cold, bleak, biting weather, and he could hear the people in the court outside go wheezing up and down, beating their hands upon their breasts and stamping their feet upon the pavement stones to warm them. The city clocks had only just gone 3, but it was quite dark already. It had not been light all day. And candles were flaring in the windows of the neighboring offices.
Hate to deflate any of Mr. Morfin's boundless enthusiasm, but I've done all I can for Mr. Claus. Jollity seems to be something for which I do not have a flair. A paper hat does not suit me. The fundamental truth is that people who are by nature content have no need of festivity. But that's not all. The 25th of December is the date of my birth, an event which by no means calls for celebration. And even that's not all. When I was a child, I never believed in Santa. I never believed in all that false friendliness which he provoked among members of a family none of whom liked one another. A few days before Christmas, my father gave me half a crown with which to buy a present for my mother, and my mother gave me a slightly larger sum to buy something for my father, and on Christmas Day, they both thanked me. Who did they think they were kidding? In England, Christmas is a reason for stopping work. Not that the English are necessarily lazy, but because they hate their employer. Well, I am not a businessman. I do not work, I do not earn money, and I do not spend money. So I try to go on at Christmas as though nothing unpleasant had happened.
And so, as Tiny Tim observed, God bless us, everyone.
Oh, humbug. Good night.
Hey, great. Their gifts have arrived from Armistead.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Another one there.
What's this then? Some sort of religious cult.
No, these are freedom rings. They started in San Francisco. They're for gay pride. They're the colors of the rainbow. Here, here.
How creative. Whatever will the gay community think of next? Dungarees, perhaps?
Sandwiches?
Yes, yes, yes.
There's salmon, love, tuna. And there's a bit of venison there, if you like. Oh, sorry, Bambi. More than welcome.
Thank you for this, darling. Yeah.
Are you sure, Flower? Yeah. Okay, I'll do you a bit of cake later.
Yes. Yeah.
Sandwich, madam. Sandwich, sir.
So Peggy Lang's there with the Queen. Sandwich. About that lovely thing. And she says, well, it can't possibly be a snake because there aren't any. Do you want us to have some more?
Sure.
Do you know? Have yourself a merry little Christmas. Make your
Yuletide gay. What
did
you miss?
Oh! Oh, dear. Oh, give us a go. Oh, quick. Quick, paramedics.
Oh, my God. Let me through. I'm a caterer. Take this man upstairs to a bedroom. Chop, chop.
No shortage of volunteers, I see.
About 8 to 10 years if you don't get these bloody bolivons in, I'm telling you.
There's something very odd about this party. Where's the amyl nitrate, for one thing? Well, wrap me in a coat dress and call me Oprah. Cam, is that you? Now, there's an outfit we wouldn't see in Farmers Weekly.
By the men. No one could touch me
night the woodman left his chopper on the stair. Nobody loves a fairy when she's 40. Nobody loves a fairy when she's old. Your fairy days are ending when your wand is always bending. No one loves a fairy when she's old.
Time to look at all the millions of cards we got from our three friends.
The first one is
Happy Holiday from the Gay New York Men's Chorus.
And here's one from Sir Ian McKellen from Hollywood.
And the third one is from Pierre et Gilles in Paris.
Bonjour Melissa.
Bonjour Andy.
Nous sommes Pierre et Gilles de Paris. Joyeux Noël.
Merry Christmas.
Hello. I don't know whether to wish that you were here or wish that I was there, but either way, wherever you are, I hope the sun's shining for you and that you have a wonderful day tomorrow. Happy Christmas.
Doorbells and sleigh bells and schnitzel and noodles.
While geese are
fly with the moon on their wings.
These are a few of my favorite things.
Girls in white dresses with blue satin sashes. Snowflakes that stay on my nose and eyelashes.
Silver white winters that melt into spring.
These are a few of my favorite things. When the dog bites, when the bee stings, when I'm feeling sad, I simply remember my favorite things. Then I don't feel so
just got back from Norway.
Oh, what have you been doing there?
They invited me down to give a talk.
Oh, what have you been talking about? Tell me.
Well, it seems that the fact that I was in the service for 26 years caught some interest, having been born in Norway.
Our government kicked this fine colonel out of the service. And now she's spreading her story, and they're going to do a movie of her. And we just can't wait until she does it. Now, what have you got there?
Well, it's something for you.
Oh, I can't wait. Another present. Look. It's a snow.
Oh. Mind you, you know, America's not that bad. You should have tried spending 14 years in Britain with Margaret Thatcher. There's a pantomime dame, if ever there was one.
What's a pantomime dame?
What do you mean, you're American. They don't know what panto is. It's theater, you know. It's like opera, only there's somebody from Blue Peter in it. What's a good one? Cinderella's a great one. Here's the story of Cinderella. The story of Cinderella is there's this young girl who lives with her father and her two sisters, and it's, like, very traditional, because it's a single-parent family, and the two sisters are both drag queens. Now, and the two ugly sisters are worried because Cinder's so pretty and they're so ugly that if she goes to the ball, the handsome prince will fall in love with Cinder's rather than them. And they're right, because the handsome prince is not a prince. He's actually a woman dressed up as a man, as is his best friend, Dandini. And she will fall in love with Cinder's rather than the ugly sisters, because they're men, Cinder's is a woman, and she's a lesbian. Are you following this? Mind you, maybe this will help.
Is here. Tony, Tony Sher, that is. The Royal Shakespeare Company. I'm really doing this as a favour to him. He asked me to play opposite him. Said he wouldn't do it if I didn't. You know, the poor love does need work.
Excuse me. I can't. Oh, damn. Could somebody please get a message to Simon Callow, please?
He's been down a real cracker of a part for this. Not actually Santa, one of his little helpers, in fact, and only understudying, but I would have got to go on for matinees. It was Selfridge's, admittedly, and not Harrod's, but, well, you can't be too choosy these days, can you? What with the Arts Council cuts and everything. You better try the bloody thing on. No, thank God for panto, I say. Keeps us all afloat. Biggins has got Aladdin. Quite which lad, I cannot, of course, reveal. Lionel's opening his buttons again at Norwich. Still plenty up for grabs, even this late in the year. Man Friday, Baron Hard Up. What about Dick? Everyone's seen your Dick. So, really, I simply don't dare to put this lot off any longer. And, of course, it was a favour to Tony.
I'm stuck. I'm trying to fit in with a proper job at the same time. This is a very proper job. This is serious theatre.
I've done car work before, of course. Marvelous experimental Swiss piece, all in mauve. Great fun. We are lilac cow. Then that big musical, the Butter One, with the little bouncy ball song sheet ran forever. Step, ball, change, kick, step, ball, change, kick.
There we are. Oh, oh, good. Thank goodness. Ah. Ah. Oh. Ah.
Is anyone out there? Just tell Simon I'm on my way. Right now.
I really fancy improvising this solo, I must admit. Tony! Tony! Tony!
No, no, come.
Oh, God. Cow. A cow. My kingdom for a cow. Tony loves me. A word in your set, love. I think...
had a threesome with him once.
Oh, yes.
Me, him, and Trigger it was on the grass verge of the M25. Happy days.
Silent night, holy night, all is calm, all is bright, round yon virgin mother and child, holy infant so tender and mild, sleep in heavenly peace, sleep in heavenly peace.
And I want you to meet everyone. Everyone, this is E17. E17, this is the distinguished Colonel Kammermeier. Colonel Kammermeier.
Do you know who she is? She used to be the chief store detective in the co-op back, and that's my Christ, and what's it for an unpaid fine?
Oh, daughter, daughter!
Holly, I'm going to be next. I've got to get out. What am I going to do?
What do you want me to do, dear?
Oh, my God.
Oh, look.
It's him.
That's what people say.
Isn't that your fiancé?
Oh, Holly.
Shut down in my...
I'm going to make him change. When I'm back,
don't let your hormones get the better of you, dear. Get away while you can.
Listen to that voice.
Some people just need to get
too late, Polly.
I remember the dream of you. Does this old world keep on giving around? I've been a puppet, a pauper, a pirate, a poet, a pawn and a queen. What I've been up and down and over and out, but I know one thing: each time I find myself the love on my face, I pick myself up and hit back in the ring. But that's life,
Colonel.
I can't deny it. I've got a quick mind. I'd roll up in a big ball and die. Traveling, I'd be a puppet. I'm bored and a queen. I'd be up and down and over and out. But Leah, I guess you know what I mean. Each time I find myself flat on my face, Jerry, I pick myself up and then I'm
mistletoe, Lily! Give us a kiss.
Simon, I wouldn't kiss you under a general anaesthetic.
Bob! Quick, let's get out of here.
Bob! Who's that arriving?
Oh, dear. Hello. I don't know who that was, I think I've just been ram raided by Ken and Barbie. Well, hello, girls and girls. Ho, ho, and to a large extent, ho. Very much my busy night of the year tonight, so I can't stay long. But I'd like to take a fag break about this time of day. Usually, round about this time of year, you'll catch me in my little grotto, drilling my young assistants, and up in Lapland, where the laps come from. Well, obviously, not the sort of laps you sit on. Though, of course, if you pay enough money, I suppose you could. No, today's my day for sliding down shafts up and down the country, and surprising children in that way I have. I think everybody young at heart likes to wake up with a little bulging something to hand on Christmas morning. And I see it very much as my job, really, to fill everybody's stockings, however sheer they may be. But I do have a number of wishes which I've been authorised to give to anybody deserving here.
Oh, Santa.
Yes, darling.
I want my boys, my little baby boys, Toby and Tim, for Christmas. Ever so bad.
No sooner said than done. Oh. Toby and Tim, come in here.
Oh, what have you done? Oh, my baby. Oh.
I'd be very happy to hold your crutch for you, if that's any use. Thank you. Quite what I meant.
I've got another wish, Santa.
Yes, all right. What
I know I'm a little greedy woman, but do you think, I think we all want that Justin will be well and all better and come and join the party?
Yeah. Oh, right, yeah. I suppose so. Justin, fashion victim, go on down.
There are presents, there are Andy, there you are. There are Melissa, there's a present. Which one do you want?
Your heart be light. Next year all our troubles will be out of sight. Have yourself a merry Christmas. Make the Yuletide gay. Next year all our troubles will be miles away. Dear to us.